Hello everyone, Emmett is here, and today I would like to talk about a topic that is a bit sensitive. When you make videos and post them on social media, from time to time you'll see this kind of comments. And today I want to answer them all. Of course, I'm talking here on my behalf, but later in the video I'm gonna have a special guest, Lukas Engström, and he will also express his opinion. So let's find out. Are foreigners living in Taiwan just brown nosers? Do you think it's true? Write a comment below. I would like to introduce my story a bit so later I can prove my point. This video is not sponsored by anyone. It's just a friendly review about one very friendly country. Taiwan isn't the first country I ever lived. I was born in Poland, but I had an experience of living in Lisbon, Portugal as an exchange student. I also lived and worked in London and the Netherlands. Later on, I moved to Macau and I lived in Shenzhen, mainland China, for a while. Moreover, I had the pleasure to visit a whole bunch of countries, mostly in Europe and Asia. Why am I saying that? Taiwan wasn't the first place I've ever been. As I just said, I've been to many, but all of these places had some benefits and disadvantages. But generally speaking, I love my experience in each of those. In each of those places, I found a piece of myself. I found what I like in my life. I found what I like about the environment. Hence, one day I ended up in Taiwan and I wasn't really planning to stay here too long, probably half a year, maybe 1 year. But Taiwan was so much better than I expected. And here, 8 years later, I'm still here. When I arrived here, soon I had realized all the things that I wanted in my life, such as good weather, good food, and good environment for development. And I had them here. And I knew I could follow my dream of being a photographer because Taiwan has a great industry, has lots of businesses and top-notch cameras in a very affordable price. So after years in Taiwan, living in such an incredible place, because of the culture they preserve for thousands of years, it is so safe to live here, almost guaranteed that if you ever lose anything, for example, whenever I realize my phone is missing or anything valuable, naturally my heart starts racing. But then you need to ask yourself one very important question, namely, where are you? If the answer is Taiwan, I know you will have your phone back very soon. I'm well traveled, but the Taiwanese remain the friendliest people I have ever met. Even if you can speak Mandarin on Taiwanese, you will find that people are more than willing to help accommodate you. Everyday life in Taiwan, like everywhere, has some minor struggles, but one of the biggest of them in Taiwan is what I'm gonna eat today, because there are so many flavors to pick from, and I really want to stay fit, so I need lots of discipline. As the years passed by, my little dream became more and more real. I also found a girlfriend who later became my lovely wife. I made lots of friends with the local people and expats living here. Apart from virtually no crime and great healthcare, economical situation in Taiwan, me and my wife decided to start a family here because Taiwan is such a great place for that. My passion for traveling has never expired. Apart from the last year during the COVID, I travel abroad almost every few months, either in Asia or Europe. And I can see different things in different places than in Taiwan. Some views, some faces, some flavors are never gonna be found here, obviously. But the thing is, you cannot fit everything in one place, can you? There are lots of travel destinations that are fun for 1 week or two, but would I ever like to live there? I honestly don't think so. Truthfully, whenever I am on plane and it takes off from Taoyuan, I feel I'm leaving my heart on the beautiful island here. And every time the wheels touch the ground again, I feel that my heart is back in my chest. People say the grass is greener on the other side, and I see Taiwan has some flaws. But what's the point of complaining about them anyways? Does it help? I don't think so. Every single place I had lived, it has some problems, and there are things that are gonna make you unhappy. The point is, you should find a place where you are happy about the most and the least complain. And I am so happy, I'm so glad, because I found that place, it's Taiwan. And it's not just me speaking from my personal experience, but there are lots of international rankings that confirm my opinions. For example, Taiwan is the first on the list of countries where the expats are the happiest. According to the Crime Index, Taiwan is the second safest country in the world. On the Where to be Born Index, Taiwan ranks 14 of 80 countries ahead of Germany, the US or Japan, which is a great score, isn't it? In Poland we say Cudze chwalicie, swego nie znacie, which means you praise others, but You don't even know your own. You live in such a beautiful country where an outsider like me can come, learn a language, make friends, and live a very happy life. If you were born in Taiwan, know the language, have friends here for years, you already won the lottery. And I'm sure you can love Taiwan more than I do. Okay, but now, how about Lucas? What does he say about this? Let's find out.
Do I love living in Taiwan? I've lived in Taiwan for 10 years, but people still continue to ask me if I do love living here in Taiwan. And of course, I've lived here for 10 years. That is a third of my entire life. So of course, I do love living here in Taiwan. But I mean, it doesn't really matter if it's Taiwan, Sweden, or any other place. There are, of course, things that you do love, and then there are things that you just don't love or not even like about any country in the world, really. But when it comes to making these YouTube videos, then I make YouTube videos just because I like to make videos. I necessarily don't make videos because I like just saying good things about Taiwan, but I've realized that that is actually, if I'm brutally honest, what most people want to hear. And I just like making videos about living here in Taiwan. So for me personally, it doesn't really matter if I tell the whole story or not. As long as I am being 100% honest in my videos, I don't really mind if I'm leaving some parts out, talking about how I do not necessarily like everything here in Taiwan. And actually, I have received several comments talking about that I'm lying and Taiwan isn't really as great as I'm making it look like in my videos. And I don't know, it may not be. I'm not trying to make Taiwan look better than it is. I'm just focusing on the positive things in my videos. But it's a little bit like if you watch a cooking show. Like, you watch the cooking show only to see like how it's being made and to see the good stuff. You don't watch a cooking show and then after they're done, you complain that they're not showing you how they do the dishes. So I feel like my YouTube videos about Taiwan are a little bit like this. I wouldn't say that it's fake, but it's also not showing you how I do the dishes here in Taiwan. And honestly, I don't think anyone would want to see that, and I don't necessarily would want to make videos about that. So I think that's where the whole confusion comes, that foreigners sometimes lie about how great life here in Taiwan is. It could be amazing. Most of the time, it really, really is. And those are the times that end up being a YouTube video, at least here on my channel.
Thanks for watching my video. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to visit Lucas' channel, because he has some great content in there. And by the way, I didn't answer a question from the title, did I? I'll answer now. Yes, I do love living in Taiwan. And if you don't believe me, keep watching my videos, keep reading my blog. There is lots of proof. If you love it as well, smash the like button. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, hit the ring, because there is lots of good content coming. Oh boy, a lot of good content. And see you next time. Goodbye.